Hi, and welcome to another TekTips video. Today we're showing you how to wire an Arduino to a ClearPath servo motor. Using one of ClearPath's many operating modes, along with an Arduino, there's virtually no limit to the types of applications you can create and accomplish. As just one example, here I've configured ClearPath to use the operating mode called Move to Absolute Positions, along with a simple Arduino sketch I wrote to index this load to multiple locations. Here's another example. By switching ClearPath's operating mode to ramp up down to selected velocity and using essentially the same Arduino sketch, we can smoothly ramp between multiple velocities. It's actually quite straightforward. Let's get started. Currently, ClearPath supports 11 unique operating modes using just 4 general purpose I/O lines. General purpose I/O is found on most everything. PLCs such as this one from Velocio, single board computers like the Raspberry Pi and the BeagleBone Black, and almost all microcontrollers like the popular Arduino. Since the Arduino supports a wide range of general purpose I/O, it's a great microcontroller to quickly develop applications with ClearPath servos. Today, we'll be accessing the digital I/O header on this Arduino Uno. We'll save analog inputs and PWM outputs for a future video. Here I'm using a NEMA 23 ClearPath motor configured to use ramp-up-down velocity mode. On my Arduino, I've mounted a shield, which is just a breakout board, that converts the native digital I/O header into a screw terminal block, making it easier to wire. I started with Technic's standard 10-foot controller cable. First, I cut it down to about 2 feet in length to make it easier to handle, and then I stripped back the wire end so it could be screwed into the shield's terminal block. Then I added a pull-up resistor and an external LED to watch for an output state. Here's the color codes for the internal conductors of this controller cable. There are 8 conductors for the 4 ClearPath I/O points. Enable, input A, and input B are the 3 ClearPath inputs and are all optically isolated for noise immunity. The input circuit is easy. It consists of 2 pins, high and low, for the internal light-emitting diode. With a proper amount of current, about 10 milliamps, an internal LED turns on and transmits light to a photoreceptor that is wired to ClearPath's internal processor. Each input has overcurrent protection, and you have the flexibility to apply a wide voltage range, from 4 to 28 volts DC. Just make sure you don't wire inductive loads, like a coil or a relay, in conjunction with these inputs, because the induced voltage spikes caused by interrupting these inductive loads can greatly exceed the voltage rating of these inputs. As a result, there are several ways to wire to the ClearPath inputs. For example, you can directly drive these inputs, either syncing or sourcing. You can also use open collector, or you can check the manual for further examples. Today, I'm going to take advantage of the Arduino's outputs. These are driven outputs that can sync or source up to 40 milliamps, so they are ideal for these type of ClearPath inputs. I've identically wired my 3 ClearPath inputs, enable, input A, and input B, to the Arduino pins 6, 8, and 9, respectively. These pins are configured as digital outputs in the Arduino, so they are just a straightforward plus 5 volts DC driven signal. There's also a configurable status output from ClearPath called HLFB, or high-level feedback. The internal circuit for HLFB is an uncommitted NPN transistor which can either pull high or low and turns on or off depending on the logic state of HLFB. Internally, like ClearPath's other 3 I/O points, HLFB is also optically isolated for noise immunity. The transistor is rated for 9 milliamps with a max voltage rating across the HLFB pins of 30 volts DC. This circuit also has overcurrent protection built in. And, like the inputs, we don't recommend using inductive loads in conjunction with this HLFB output. So a recommended way of wiring to HLFB is to use a voltage source, 5 to 24 volts nominally, with a pull-up resistor so you can read the voltage drop across that resistor. With our Arduino wiring to HLFB, I started with one of the Arduino's plus 5 volt DC pins and wired this in series with an LED and an 866 ohm pull-up resistor. Alternatively, you could simply configure the Arduino input to use its own internal pull-up resistor. This is rated at 20 to 50 kilo-ohms. In the end, here's the wiring table showing all the pertinent pin numbers and grounds. What about some of the relevant Arduino commands to make our ClearPath motor execute these velocity moves? Let's look briefly at the Arduino variable declaration section in the code. Here we define the pin numbers we just wired, as well as pin 13, which is Arduino's onboard LED. The variable names enable, input A, and input B are all configured as Arduino outputs going to their respective ClearPath inputs. HLFB, on the other hand, is configured as a standard input. You can also configure it to use Arduino's internal pull-up. Let's now use the MSP software to highlight and show the setup portion of this code running. Here's the O-scope and strip chart within MSP. I've set the time base to 500 milliseconds per division. I've also captured a single trigger on the scope showing the execution of the setup portion of our code. After enabling the motor, we read the HLFB input and, when true, turn on the LED and then wait for 1 second. Finally, we disable the motor, read the HLFB input again, and if false, turn off the LED and wait for 1.5 seconds. For HLFB, remember that the electrical logic is reversed due to the pull-up. When HLFB is true, the internal optocoupler transmits light, turning on the NPN transistor. This causes current to flow and the Uno sees the voltage drop across the pull-up resistor. The opposite naturally happens when HLFB is false. After running through the setup portion of the code, the software drops down into the main loop. Here, the motor is enabled, followed by a 500 millisecond dwell before executing a new velocity move. The strip chart on the bottom shows the on-off states of the inputs and outputs as the code runs. Finally, let's look at the inputs and commands section of MSP itself. Here we can see the various input bits turning on and off, as well as the status of HLFB as the code executes. So that's about it. In summary, it's very easy to wire and configure an Arduino with ClearPath to develop applications like these. I hope this TekTips video on wiring an Arduino to ClearPath has been helpful. If so, please click the thumbs up like button. Click the Technic logo to subscribe and you'll be notified whenever we release a new video. And please feel free to comment and ask questions. We love getting feedback. It's often very helpful for everyone. Thanks for watching.